Hello, my name is Taylor Steele. I'm gonna do director commentary for you. This intro is a little darker, a little heavier, scarier. This is Matt Bushane's idea. He thought Campaign One was a little too bright, so he wanted to bring it darker. And I thought it was a good idea. Good contrast from the skits that we have coming up later, too. And these graphics, Jeff Motil designed with Dustin Humphrey photos to him. Yeah, getting these photos of all the guys are a lot tougher than it looks. Tracking them down just for a 5-minute photo shoot is a lot of work, I'll tell you. But I think it came out how we all envisioned, so we're stoked with that. And this song is Uncle, and it's a cool song. I think that's here's the start of the skit. We changed all this around. If you look close, there's a C2 on that computer. Originally, it started with Timmy in a window with a mannequin, but we tried to speed up the whole movie. And this was all shot with Kelly in Bali. And yeah, I'm moving the light to give it sort of a scary like effect. I don't know if you even noticed that, but trying to get all the little details going. And this is Todd Heater shot all these skits. He did a great job with that. And I thought each guy sort of got into character and they went for it. So it was a lot of fun to shoot these things. This is right down my street. We've shot a lot of skits there from the show on. Everybody asks how come Rob's always riding a bike, but we're sort of doing a homage to all the surf movies and some of the my old ones too, like Loose Change. Everybody's a character from a past movie, except Benji and Bat Dude. But that's Shanghai Sex. That's from Doped Youth. And this is all shot in front of a green screen, obviously. And yeah, we're making fun of the 1950s surf movies there. Shane was awesome to work with on this. He really just had a lot of fun and just went for it. Everybody thinks he's sort of more conservative than he really is once you get to know him. So it's cool to show that. And this is Marcus. He's from Brazil. We met him on the drive through South America, and we were stoked we were able to get that clip of him because that was crazy. And this one of Andy we had in a section, but it just wouldn't fit, so it was perfect for the opening. A lot of the opening shots are just shots that don't really fit in their guys' parts or guys that don't have parts. And that's probably the first contest footage I used of Timmy right there is probably the first contest footage I've ever used. And this one of Dane is that's the best rodeo I've seen. Now, when we shot this Damien clip, I didn't know what to expect when how Damien would do with this role, and he just jumped right into it and did much better than I thought. He blew me away, actually. He just dove into it and, went for it. And this is all shot in reverse, so everything he did, he would do backwards beforehand, and he, yeah. We were going to put a Jack Johnson song to this to sort of do a parody on it, but I don't know if anybody would have got that from his music video. And that's in my living room right there. And this shot of CJ is just the craziest paddle and wave ever, I think. It's just super heavy. Legendary right there. And this is from our boat trip we did a little while ago, on the Komodo. It was with CJ and Andy and Dane and Shane. And we used a lot of that through all those guys' sections. And these clips, he's just going off. I don't know what to say for that, but he's just ripping. Yeah, I would like to have given CJ his whole part. We just only had this one trip to go off of, and for this movie, it seemed tougher to lock down some guys and easier for other guys. So, yeah, next time for sure. And some more Tahiti. And then Damien's stuff is from Australia. Beach breaks in middle of the coast, in between Queensland and Sydney. And this is Luke Steadman. This is from Reunion Island. And Dan's from Bali. All these shots are in Bali. There's some new little waves over there. Don't like to give out where they are, but they're really rippable rights. And this is in Europe, I think. I really can't remember, but no. This might be Africa. I don't know. Portugal, maybe. And then this is Rizal in Bali, in his home spots. This is Bingen. And that's a different angle for a Matawi's wave. This is some of those waves in Bali that we don't like to mention where they're at. There's a lot of great surfers from Bali. They're going to be making a huge push in the next couple of years. I think you'll just be seeing more and more guys from Bali that are just owning the video sections and photos. They already do, but more so. And even from Brazil, too. This is where Marcos is from, and he's doing some incredible stuff right here. That definitely grabbing some attention. And Ozzy, we wanted to do some more filming with him to get a bigger section because he has his skits and stuff, but he's so busy being an artist, musician, surfer, skater, you name it. So we're lucky to get what we got. All this is shot in our Steelhouse Australia warehouse, and it was a lot of fun to do. These guys are classic characters to work with, Tashenka and Ozzy. We had a fun time. We just sort of made up their skit on the spot, probably shows, but it was a lot of fun regardless. And they made their costumes and, you know, spray painted on the walls to get the set all perfect. And yeah, it was a fun couple days we did shooting this. This is Rye's section now. Rye's stuff is all at his home break. You know, where he lives is just some perfect, incredible waves. I guess it's pretty sharky too, but the waves are just flawless, no one out, and in the desert, really. He's a lucky kid to have that as his backyard, and no crowds, really. I don't think there's much else to do but surf there, so that's probably why he's just such a good surfer. But I haven't been to that area, so I wouldn't know for sure. But I don't think there's too many malls there. And this is one of my favorite songs in the movie. this is from our Pelagic trip. This is a trip that Luke set up. Yeah, we got great waves on it and found a couple new spots that a lot of guys have been going to lately. But yeah, it was nice to surf some brand new secret spots that are perfect. Benji's section has a lot of them from there too. Benji was on the same trip with him. And yeah, it's pretty much all Goofy Foots except for Benji. And all this stuff that Rye got, his friend shot and submitted it to us. Excuse me. Yeah, and that wave, it started off like a head-high wave and then just ends up double overhead. It's a pretty different looking wave. If you look around, that's pretty much what Rye's house looks like. And the funny thing about shooting these skits is that we shot them in like four different countries. Bali, U.S., Australia, and Mexico. We pretty much made up Benji's skit on the spot after we got his wardrobe together and his outfit, that he was going to be a gay Brazilian or Mexican, and he just ran with it. You know, you give Benji a role that has anything gay in it, and he'll do a great job at acting with it. And I love this song for Joel. Joel's style is so smooth that it goes really good with a little bit of a hip-hop beat, like Gorillaz. This is all by his house, little beach breaks. I think this is Duramba. I like it because it looks like a little bit different than normal Duramba. Normally, it all looks the same, but that looks a little bit different. This shot I'm shooting from Kelly's apartment on the 11th floor, right above Snapper. And then this is just down the coast. There's a lot of good breaks down the coast, a lot of secret spots. And this is all just down the coast on one really clean day. And this was green screened, and Sam Yago cut Shane out and put him in that scene. He did a great job with it. And all this Sean Kansdell stuff was submitted by his friends, and this is by his house. And yeah, the thing that impressed me most about Sean is just every maneuver, even his stuff that we didn't use, he doesn't really fall. He barely falls. He's always above his board, and he always seems to pull it off somewhere, somehow. Like, he's just really solid on his board. I think he's going to qualify this year, and it shows. Like, he'd be perfect for contests, especially because he never falls, and he still does radical maneuvers. Master combos right here, just going off. Watching his section makes me miss Australia. There's just so many good beach breaks and little point waves that aren't that crowded if you get out of the cities. But yeah. This song was a little bit of a bummer for us because we had another song in there and we had to replace it. And whenever you're editing to music and editing surfing especially, it's just, you find the song that really works and it just almost feels like magic when you get it. And so when you take that song out and you put another song in, even if it's a good song like this song is, it just never feels right. It always feels a little bit off. And yeah, this one's growing on me, this song, but it still feels a little off from what it was. And for this shot, Luke said it was a little sketchy to ride that moped in Bali one-handed, because he's not that comfortable riding mopeds already, so one-handed, he was not that comfortable. And all this stuff of Benji is in the Caribbean. I don't like to say where it is, but we got really lucky when we were there and got one of the better swells of the last couple years. So, yeah, it was a really huge hassle to get there, because everybody's tickets were to another island and we had to change that to go to where the swell was. But when we got there, we just scored. So that's what it's all about on those trips, is actually just the end result. And so, you do whatever it takes to get there. And Benji picked this song out. He heard some of our early tracks that we had saved for the movie, and he fell in love with this song and demanded that we use it for a section. And so he was shooting the whole year to try to fill this song up, because he knew the breaks and he knew all that stuff. So it was really fun to work with him on that level, knowing that he knew what he sort of needed to get for it also. And so he would listen to it and then go surf and try to get those kind of clips. I think it shows. And this song also, to me, feels great, for barrels. It sort of just fits the kind of barrel riding, and Benji's section has a lot more barrels than he normally does, and so it's perfect for that. All this is from that pelagic trip that we did with Luke. Yep, and then that's back to the Caribbean, and then back to that's the secret spot that I told you about that we found. A lot of guys are surfing now. I think there's a wave in Young Guns on it, but yeah, that's one of those spots. This was a fun day. We went in the middle of nowhere, and my cousin Rob Sorensen, he let us borrow his Harley and let Donovan ride around on it all day, and we just filmed these things. Donnie cracks me up. You just put a camera on him, and he's just on. He takes a couple takes to, get the lines right, but even if the lines are wrong, he's still hilarious. So, and then this was a tarantula we found on the spot. We just threw it in the shot. Timmy's song I love. I think it's a little bit different for Timmy, but it fits perfectly his surfing in these kind of waves. Timmy is with us down in the Caribbean, so we got lucky on this swell. And Timmy's backhand surfing, nobody's really seen him surf those kind of waves. A lot of people think it's backdoor, but they're like, how would Timmy get waves at backdoor like that? And that's because it's the Caribbean. So and this is some more waves down there in the Caribbean. For each movie, I try to get the guys in different locations. Timmy's pretty much barred from shooting at a couple spots by his house, unless he gets a really different look. And this is one of those different looks. He's got a silver wetsuit, and just surfing, really progressive. But I feel that, no matter how good you're surfing, if it looks like you've seen it before, seen that kind of thing somewhere else or in another movie or anything, it takes away from the surfing. So I always try to get the guys in new spots or new wetsuits or new airbrush, anything to spice up the footage, because you want it to feel fresh, brand new, and something you haven't seen before. And that's Timmy's friend right there, not just a random guy that he's hugging. This is Blakey's car. Blakey worked on the whole script with me, and he actually wrote it, and then he came out and helped film it all. And it was a lot of fun shooting it with him. I know after he left, I had to shoot a couple more skits, and I was a little bit lost without him. So, yeah, it's definitely nice to have two guys filming all this stuff, and so you can bounce ideas off and make sure we get all the shots and whatnot. Rostovich, this is all one day. In May of 05, by his house, and it's just like I think he surfed for 7 hours, and it just shows you how good of a tube rider he is, and how like in sync he was this day with the waves. And we toyed around with using different waves from like Bali or other sessions, but for some reason, just this day looked so magical to us that it was tough to like change the vibe of it and put different waves in. It was almost fun just to keep it pure one session that's just from that one session. Yeah. So this is all. One day, 7 hours, and Rasta. I don't think it was very crowded this day, and it was pretty flawless. This Interpol song goes perfect to the feel of these barrels for me. This is at Embargo in Bali, and Rizal helped set this up with Dustin, and those guys were super great. They cleared out their whole bar, and we stopped the street, traffic in the street, and it was just like VIP special treatment, which you wouldn't be able to do anywhere else in the world. So it was a lot of fun to shoot skits in Bali. This stuff right here, we're shooting it, and we happen to be by a golf course and just making a loud ruckus. They're on a trailer, and that's because Dan didn't know how to ride a Harley, and so the owner of the Harley wouldn't let Dan learn how to ride it on his Harley. So we put him on a trailer to make up for it. It was a creative way around the situation, which always seems to come up when you're shooting skids, some sort of situation. This is Mike, Swivel Hips. Mike's one of those surfers that he surfs a lot like Aki and Rob for me, but he just has his own style. I don't know. He turns from his hips and I don't know, just the lines he draws is really fun to watch because he doesn't really look like that many other surfers. But backside, he reminds me of Aki off the bottom and Rob off the top, so it's cool in that sense. But frontside, he's got his own thing going completely, I think. And most of this stuff is in Bali. There's a lot of little beach breaks and secret spots we go to in Bali, and this is one of those little secret spots. That wave is really long point wave. It's just for video sections. You don't want to show the whole point of it because it gets sort of boring, and there's sections that you just are passing up to make the next section. So we try to keep these sections pretty tight, and we've cut down the songs a lot to keep them tight. Pretty much everybody's section is a minute shorter than normal, so That's just to make I felt in campaign one that maybe the sections were just a little too long, and when you're stretching out and filling it in, it doesn't really work. This is a little Point Break parody with the ex-presidents. And Taj's footage is one of those last minute cramming session, you know, doing your homework on the night before the it's due, or anything that where you just procrastinate. Taj procrastinated a little bit on this one and got me the footage very last minute. He came over to Bali, watched what everybody else had, and then just went off and just got the footage with 1 week to go. And I don't know how he did it. I didn't think he was going to. As incredible of a surfer as he is, I didn't think he was going to be able to pull it off. But in Taj fashion, he does. And his song and surfing are one of my favorites. It just really fits. Taj has this sort of futuristic kind of surfing, and I think this song has that kind of feel too. That's from Reunion right there. So are these little rights. And I don't know where that is. I'm sure it's somewhere in Australia. I just don't know where. Taj got me this footage a week after my due date, but still snuck it in. And this Kelly scene, we shot the morning he was supposed to leave. He got up at 7 and said he had to get to California for some promo or something. And he was late for the airport, so I told him we had to shoot the skit that morning. And we busted it out in 10 minutes, and then he got to the airport and he missed his flight. So I apologize if I was the reason that you missed your flight, Kelly. Dane's section. Dane's stuff's all from One Boat Trip, and which nobody else in this whole movie really has stuff from just one trip. Rasta has stuff from one session, but it's a shorter song. Dane has his whole section from one trip, and just shows you how progressive he is surfing on this trip. He was really going off. We had other stuff from him from Australia and France, but it really was taken away from the flow of all this footage. Sometimes going to different spots helps the surfer section, and other times it takes away from it, and in this case it was taken away from it in our eyes. I really like the way Dane surfs backside over shallow reef. He goes for it. He just throws his board up there and then gets over his board on the airdrop down. So it's really fun to watch. This turn he really didn't want in the movie, so we had to talk him into getting it in there. But I think this one he was okay with us leaving it in there. I like how he goes right into a combo after that. Yeah, he's all these waves are fun to put back to back, because then it just shows like how much he was going for it in this whole trip. This is at that embargo place. They were great to let us use their place, and thank you for that. All right. Well, this is Jamie O'Brien. Jamie's the freak show. His section got some of the guys really excited to get their sections better. I remember we were watching it with Benji and Kelly and a couple guys, and they watched it and they went, wow, he's got one of every single turn you could have in his section. He's got big barrels, he's got carving 360s, rodeos, you name it, he's got it in his section. And I know that helped fire up some of the guys to shoot some more last minute stuff and work on their sections. I remember we first played this song for Jamie, and he wasn't really feeling it, but I don't know, for me it just sort of fit the surfing that we were seeing. It's a little bit of a futuristic kind of a feeling to the song, but a sort of 70s feel also. Most of this stuff shot either in Bali most of this stuff's Bali. It's really been the most productive place for me lately, in the last couple of years, just because it has a big variety of waves. And Jamie usually has a guy that videos for him, and so he submitted all this footage with his crew that he hires to shoot for him. So it was great to work with him on that level, and I can't wait to do more trips with him, because he seems like he's in a high percentage of making incredible stuff. Yeah, these switch foot waves at backdoor. That one he said he got worked on. This one is with Mike Stewart. Pretty crazy wave. And that's Dan Malloy. Dan's wearing Donnie's outfits that he normally just wears. I just said, Donnie, bring a couple extra outfits. And this Rob stuff we shot in a completely different location and just faked that it was there. We could pull it off. That was me doing a stunt double on it. And then this is back at where Barney did his skit, but not at the same time that Barney was there. So a lot of these things we didn't know if they're going to work. We just shot them and then we're hoping that it worked. Some worked, some didn't, and some have a little bit of need a little bit more, but it works. Bruce, in my eyes, he does the highest airs out of anybody. Sometimes guys even think that they're toe airs because he gets so high, but that air wasn't a toe air. Neither was that. Yeah, I don't think Bruce has anything of toe in this section, especially not this one. This one's a paddle in. You watch the trick tips, you can see that. Certain guys are good at toeing in. Taj is. I'm sure there's other guys too that are really good at it. But Bruce, I found that he did higher airs when he was doing them without toeing. Because we tried towing in later, and he just, his timing was a little off. He might be better at it now, but when we were shooting it, he wasn't that good at it, and that was like a year ago. I'm pretty legendary that wins the Quicksilver Eddie first year out. Yeah, it's crazy now that all the top guys surf 100-foot waves, 1-foot waves, do huge airs, tube ride with good style, and they could do it all. Like, there's never been a more complete time for pro surfers' abilities.
What's up, guys? I'm taking over Taylor's shift. I hit him over the head and he's knocked out. He's been working me too hard. So my name is Matt Boshane. I'm the creative director and editor and music and amongst other things. Here we go into Andy's part, one of my favorite parts. One of the things that we got a lot of compliments on, I think, from the surfers as well as other people, was the soundtrack. It's got a lot more mainstream feel to it, I guess, amongst other things as well. Andy's whole section was shot on one Indo trip. We opted just to use one trip instead of putting sporadic waves from other locations that was shot on the CT. That was the Komodo trip with Transworld. Obviously, you guys noticed Shane was on it, CJ, and Dane. Dane's part is kind of the same as Andy's in the regard that it was all shot on one trip. Chopu definitely had a big year for us. We got all this footage towards the end of editing, so it really spruced everything up. We definitely needed it, and so we're stoked that big swell came, and we were able to capitalize on that part of the leg. That backside hit was ridiculous. I think it was very underrated. Taylor actually just left. Had to leave just right now and get in a car and go to Japan and China for sipping Jetstream. So he seriously could not finish the commentary because he's going to miss his flight in LAX. So be looking for that film coming up. So I think it was the first time Taylor's ever used Waimea in his movie. I don't know, I could be wrong, but the Eddie was crazy this year, so we thought it'd be a good little something to spice up the movie, a little something different. As you can tell, my voice is almost gone. I can barely breathe through my nose. We've been working for the last 2.5 months on the film, just completely night and day. Yeah, I hate Taylor Steele. No, I'm just joking. Dead President, little Point Break ripoff, I'm sure Taylor already talked about. A lot of these skits were shot at separate times. Like that was in California there, that shot here is in Australia. So it was quite a clusterfuck, if you will, trying to put everything together. This air right here was actually shot on Drive-Thru Europe, and it was so good. Greg Browning let Taylor and I keep it for campaign two. Also Kelly was the main factor in that, I'm sure. After Kelly ruling Barbados trip, as well as getting a lot of footage when he's out on the CT with Dave MG, we left Drive-Thru Europe and told Kelly, you know, me and Taylor were going straight up to Bali to actually edit for about 3 weeks. He got word of that and he basically jumped ship and came with us and just hung out there for the whole 3 weeks. There you see here some of his footage that came in last point. He had a lot of frontside barrels from Barbados, so we were kind of, you know, even to take, you know, cutting some of the gnarliest barrels you've ever seen is hard to do. It's kind of almost something that needs to happen so you get that variety in there. You don't want it just to be back-to-back-to-back-to-back frontside barrels. So it was actually a really good opportunity for him to go to Bali and switch up, like you see here, some more Bali, switch up his footage and just have some snaps and airs and variety. I remember when we got this Barbados footage in from Dave MG, obviously I heard how gnarly the trip was. But when we got it in, it took me, I think it took me like 4 or 5 days to go all through the footage, which for a Taylor trip is ridiculously long because it's just straight surfing, opposed to something like the drive-thru, which is all lifestyle, which can take that long. But Kelly had something like 550 usable waves from this trip, which is, I mean, is just a complete, I mean, I've never seen anything like it. I don't think Taylor has either. Right there, we thought it would be cool to show him, before he started getting good waves. It took him a while to warm up and actually figure out what the hell's going on out there, but he definitely figured it out. So we thought it would be cool to show just a little bit of setup waves of him, you know, trying to feel the place out before he just gets barrels like this one. Luckily, I think this was the day before, so it was a little bit smaller, so he was actually doing some turns and weird floaters like that. I don't know what that was. He was actually talking to me about how on that wave, he thinks he can start riding the backs of waves. If they're big enough and they have a big enough slope on the back to actually floater up and pump up there and come back down. Which, if that's not progression of surfing right there, I don't know what is. This was pretty much he should have eaten it right there for sure, but nope, he pulled it. That's Benji on the inside he's pointing to right there, about to get swallowed by that wave. See, Kelly had so much footage, like I was talking to you about, he almost got his own opening section at the end of his part, which is, you know, something new that we really haven't done, but, you know, it's got that much footage, we gotta try it. That air right there was actually done in Japan, of all places. A lot of these pickup shots that you see, like that coaster going by, we actually shot 2 or 3 days before the movie came out. We were shooting a day up until the film had to be done, which, you know, like I said, Taylor's trying to kill me. Trying to break my soul, but I can break his. Definitely something else to check out on the DVD is the outtakes. Pretty funny. There's a lot, you know, all these guys trying to act. It's pretty much back-to-back-to-back funny stuff. There's definitely some funny ones from this train scene here. Shane's being a trooper, making fun of himself from In God's Hands. But check it out. Shane's part was moved to the end. It was actually before Andy's part for a while, just because we wanted to switch up the songs and we wanted to kind of get the variety of the footage. So he was kind of third to last, but after we watched the film as a whole and we actually talked to Kelly at the first Malibu premiere we had, that was the order. And Kelly pretty much wanted Shane to have the last part, just because, not as a gimme by any means, it was just, you know, we needed to look, aside from trying to mix up the music and trying to mix up the footage to make it, you know, go through the movie just evenly, and just Shane's part, just hands down, was ridiculous. It's shot all across the world. He's got big waves, small waves, and I mean his last wave, his last Chopu wave, which you guys will see coming up here, was actually he flew in from Tahiti straight to San Diego with the tape, gave it to us I think a day before the movie had to be done, and we dropped it in just before I think the first premiere we had. And right there, that was pretty much the clincher. I mean, that this last wave you're going to see is pretty much the most ridiculous Chopu wave I think any of us have ever seen. So I think that was a clincher for him, and I'm stoked for him that we were able to give him the last part, because he completely deserves it, especially because he's the star of the skits as well. Just kind of fits in well. But he's definitely killing it here. This is that same Andy Dane CJ Komodo trip that everybody was on. Or no, not everybody, those guys, actually. This is actually Morocco. A lot of people think this is Jay Bay, but it's not. It's is Morocco, which is just a ridiculous wave. I think it's like 12, 13 second barrel, if you count it. Pretty ridiculous. This whole trip here, you don't see a lot of this footage because this trip is for Taylor's other film, Sipping Jet Streams. They're actually shooting 16 millimeter this whole time, so we just wanted to use a few waves for Morocco. Barbados is also a trip for that movie, but we pretty much had to use Kelly's waves and a lot of Benji's waves and stuff like that. Taylor shot those while the guy named Todd is actually doing the DPing for that movie. And that's all, like I said, on Super 16. So that's going to be super crazy to see those Kelly barrels. They had a water 16 guy in the water. So that should be pretty interesting to check out. I haven't seen any of it to this day, but we can't wait. Here come these Chopu waves I was talking about. This one, like if you look at this one is small compared to the next one. So, I mean, that kind of puts it in perspective for you. Right there, that was pretty weird. If you look inside that barrel, there's actually a bigger wave than most people's sections, like off the lip of the of it, you know what I mean? this was a last minute skit that we shot a day before the movie was supposed to come out. Benji actually wasn't even in the film as a skit character until a day before the movie. And I'm sure Taylor talked about this already, but he actually created this character within a day. Enrique, he's gay, he's, I don't know, he's Mexican, he's, I don't, we really don't know to this day like what he is. He looks like a gay Elton John, but that's kind of an oxymoron right there. I don't know. There's another funny deal right here. This is actually Taylor doing the VO for his own skit because we had to did this the night before the movie had to come out. You see how much stuff we did about, you know, a day or two before the movie actually came out. It's, yeah, like I said, Taylor tries to kill me every film, but somehow I keep coming back for more. This is that wipeout is from the same day that Shane got that crazy barrel, which was just ridiculous. This is a pretty funny little wipeout section, actually. This, I think this kid was like 10 or something, or maybe like even younger, 8 o'clock. That kid who just got lit up right there, and he was charging Barbados. Taylor said it was just completely going for it. And that's Russell Winner right there, just getting smacked. Surprisingly enough, there wasn't that many wipeouts from the Barbados trip. I mean, Kelly just doesn't really fall. Oh, this is a big one right here. It was at Jaws. That day, actually, Shane got that big left in the beginning of his part. But this is pretty much where we sign off. Thanks for everybody watching. Taylor appreciates it. I appreciate it. And check out Drive Through South America. No, South America already came out. Drive Through Africa. That's how retarded I am. Talk to you guys later.
Glad I didn't get that role.
Silly bitch.
Should I be gay?
Oh, listen, girls, you know, this is Enrique. Oh, you guys do have to surf movie? Ooh, what's that? Is this a surfer movie out there? You guys that shit?
Told you between fate and truth lies a destiny that you can't even possibly imagine. That was a good one.
Do that for every line.
road there. Where are you going?
Going to Hollywood, man. I gotta be there in 24 hours.
Hollywood, if she could. Here, put the hands on. That's as far as I go, compadre.
Thanks for the ride, man.
Hey, no worries. That was 100% pure adrenaline rush. That was fucking...
Thanks for the ride, man.
Hey, no worries, man. That was 100% pure adrenaline rush. Awesome. Oh, that's it. End of the road for you, compadres. As far as I go.
Thanks for the ride, man.
Hey, no worries, man. That was fucking the ultimate 100% pure adrenaline rush. Right on. Hey, so Johnny, Utah. Take care, man.
Hey, my name's Shane, man.
Whatever.
That's so good. That was so good.
She's a god above. Give me cardinal sin, sensual head. The betrayal vision that I'm dead. Tonight I want you. We'll be right back.
see things in life, and you'll be surprised what you see. Life, your whole life is changes. You go through changes in your life. One second, you got it made. Next second, you're down in the dumps. And it goes back and forth throughout your whole life. One second, you got the most beautiful girl in the world. Next second, you don't even have a girlfriend no more. And it goes back and forth and back and forth, you know? And this is life, man. It's changes. This is what you got to go through throughout your whole lifetime. Never, never land.
Take show me how you're moving. Go ahead, put your back into it. Do your thing like it ain't nothing to it. Shake, shake that ass, girl. Little mama, show me how you're moving. Go ahead, put your back into it. Do your thing like it ain't nothing to it. Shake, shake that ass, girl.
World
premiere. Go in the house, bounce. Y'all already know what I'm about. The flow sounds sick over Dre drums, nigga. I ain't stupid, I see Doc. Then my dope come quicker. Whoa, shorty hips is hypnotic. She moves, she's so erotic. Watch, I'm like, bounce that ass, girl. I get it crump in here. I make it jump in here. Front in here, we'll thump in here. Oh, so gutter, so ghetto, so hood. So gully, so grimy, what's good? Outside the Benz on dubs, I'm in the club with the snub. Don't start nothing, it won't be nothing. Little mama, show me how you're moving. Put your back into it. Do your thing like it ain't nothing to it. Shake, shake that ass, girl. Little mama, show me how you're moving. Go ahead, put your back into it. Do your thing like it ain't nothing to it. Shake, shake that ass, girl.
Let's party, everybody stand up. Everybody put your hands up. Let's party, everybody bounce with me. Some champagne and burn a little greenery. It's hot. Disco Inferno, let's go. You're now rocking with a pro. I get dough to flip dough to get more for show. Get my drink on and get on the dance floor. Look at me, I don't dance, all I do is this. It's the same two-step with a little twist. Listen, peppin', I ain't new to this, I'm true to this. Pay attention, boy, I teach you how to do this. Should we mix a little Chris with a little Dom Perignon and a little Hennessy, you know we finna carry on. Smiling at the streets in the club trying to get right. We gon' be up in this bitch till we break daylight. Daylight.
Little mama, show me how you're moving. Go ahead, put your back into it. Do your thing like it ain't nothing to it. Shake, shake that ass, girl. Little mama, show me how you're moving. Go ahead, put your back into it. Do your thing like it ain't nothing to it. Shake. Shake that ass, girl.
You see it shining, lit up with diamonds, cause I stay grinding. Homie, you could catch me swooping, Bentley cooping, switching lanes. If you see me rolling, you know I'm holding, I'm out my paper. Yeah, nigga, I'm serious, I ain't playing, I'll embed it in your brain, I'm off the chain. G-Unit.
Start. Kiss. Why can't I get just one kiss? Maybe some things I wouldn't miss. But I look at your pants and I need a kiss. Why can't I get just one screw? Why can't I get just one screw? Leave me, I know what to do. But something won't let me make love to you. Life for just one day after day, I get angry, and I will say that the
I was scared, the ones that
your knapsack in your backpack. This melody your girlfriend contact. Some boy not notice. I'm only come around like tourists on the beach with a few club sodas. Bedtime stories and pose like them name Chuck Norris. And don't know the real hard pork or sandals and no back to. He talks them with the way them got to. And won't think twice to shot you. Don't make them spot you unless you carry guns and lot too. A beer tough thing come at you. When trench town man stop laugh and block off traffic. Then them wheel and pop off and them start drop it. We dip in file long and it a be trapping. Police come in a jeep and them can't stop it. Some say them a playboy rabbit. Get dropped like a bad habit. Son of a da post off if you're down to it. Rastafari stands alone. Pure ghost and phantom. The youth them get blind by stardom. Now the king of kings are called. Whole man to pick me. So brave you no know, one if you with me. To see this operation sick me. Them suit not fit me. To win election them trick with. Then them down to nothing at all. Come on let's face it. I get our education's basic. And most of the youth them waste it. And when them waste it, that's when them take the guns, replace it. Then them don't stand a chance at all. And that's why enough little youth have up some fatmatic. With the extra magazine in a them back pocket. And a bleach at night time in a some black jacket. All who not lock glocks and them a lock rocket. Them we fully up a cover.
drive. I gotta live and let live, I gotta learn to forgive. You know that everybody's got a right. But there's evil all around in this broken down city. It's a 24-hour fight, yeah, yeah.
Hollywood!
Oh, wow, I'm so happy I'm here right now.
Still in Hollywood!
My mind, I'm running on a reel and I don't know why.
Still in Hollywood!
Oh, wow, I'm so happy I'm here
Please. This song's called Prison Bound.
Oh, I'm present bound. Tell my girl I'm in.
got young.
I come to you with distressing news. Hollywood is planning a multi-billion dollar motion picture on surfing, and they want a real surfer for the lead. Unfortunately, word has it that Patrick Shane Dorian is already on his way to the audition. Now, we've all seen In God's Hands. Sit deep. Line up with the tree on the point. The wind came up the face is like nothing you've ever felt. And we don't want that to happen. If Shane gets this part, it could be years, centuries, before another surf movie is made. Your mission, should you choose to accept it, is to stop Shane from making that audition at all costs. Do it!
Must beat Dorian. Must achieve the victory.
Gotta do it for the East Coast. Do it for the Bank Coast. East Coast glory.
To the Batmobile.
Hello?
Hello, it's me, Enrique.
Hey, Enrique, what's happening, man? Hey, buddy, how's Tinseltown?
Days is good. Hey, I might have a movie for you. It's like this surf movie or something.
Are you serious? What are you doing? Just book me a first class ticket.
Okay.
I'll be there ASAP. Damn, what are you doing to me, man?
Thanks for the ride, boys. Hey, you're Rocky. You won the OP Pro twice. Yoo-hoo! Yeah.
Okay, Enrique, like, tell me, like, am I surfing in this fleet? Like, who else is going for it? I mean, geez, what's the pay? What's the, I mean, do you reckon I'll get it?
What's going on?
It's on.
It's on?
Yep.
It's on.
Let's do this.
It's on.
Yeah,
it's on. Let's go. Yeah.
I'll be in Hollywood in 24 hours.
Hollywood? Bunch of freaks in Hollywood. You want to go, though, you got to put this on. Yeah.
Hey, you know that?
I don't know if it'll fit.
This ain't exactly my style, but I'll rock it. What is this thing, a rabbit?
No. That's Beaver.
That's Beaver?
Yeah, no, I just had it stuck. Ah.
Okay.
Whoa.
Hang on, I'm gonna have to call you back. Hello, ladies. What are you up to? So, ladies, did I tell you how I'm gonna be in a massive surf flick? Yeah, I'll tell you all about it right now. Keen for a drink? Yeah, can I get a refill and keep them coming, eh?
I'm gonna be in a massive surf flick? Yeah, I'll tell you all about it right now.
Don't you wish your girlfriend was hot like me? Don't you wish your girlfriend was
Update now. Has Dorian been stopped? He's still on the way to the audition. Where are my hitmen? Damo's missing. The presidents aren't anywhere to be found.
This is what happens when you send monkeys to do man's job.
That's all I got, as far as I go, compadre.
Right on, man. Hey, man, thanks for the ride, buddy.
No worries, that was 100% pure adrenaline. That was the ultimate rush.
Hey, thanks for the beaver, I appreciate it.
Right on. Hey, so Johnny, Utah, take care, man.
Hey, Utah? Hey, my name is Shane.
Whatever.
Holy tornadoes! That's the evil president! Let's get him!
Wait a minute. There he is! There's Dorian!
Dorian! We'll get you next time!
Oh, gosh. Gotcha!
That's right. You guys are going to the slammer.
No!
Crime does not pay.
You're a surfer, aren't you? What if I told you there's a movie, a Hollywood movie, that actually made surfers look cool? What if I told you that between fate and truth lies a destiny that you can't even possibly imagine? What if I told you I had a friend who can tie his shoelaces while wearing boxing gloves?
See, you're an idiot.
Oh, really? Or am I a genius? They're trying to stop you, you know. They don't want you to be in the film. Damn.
Yeah, real scary, buddy. You're an idiot. I'm out of here.
When the wave breaks here, don't be there. When the wave breaks here, don't be there.
You been here for that surf movie?
When the wave breaks here, don't be there.
Girl, you know this is Enrique. You here for that surfer movie? That role's been filled. Ooh.
What? Who could have gotten it?
In the year 2035, a nuclear fallout will melt every block of wax in the world. With no traction, the best surfers on Earth will all become hopeless kooks. All except one. Now, the man with the last piece of wax in existence must try to stay alive long enough to reach the beach and shred one last epic session. Beyond Thunderdome.